Hey, Stephen, how are you doing?
Good, Ricky. How about you?
Good. Thank you for doing this interview with me and also let me grab your testimonial.
Of course.
Let's get started. So I want to introduce you to the audience as well. So you presented in the Pi User Conference 10 years ago. How long?
That I think was in just after 2010, so maybe I think somewhere around 2010, I think.
Oh, and who do you work for before?
At the time, it was Alliance Pipeline.
Oh, and what was the, is it, you present, you represent with them, right?
Yes.
For them.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, well, that's great. And you recently go to the conference as well, right?
Yeah, we're at Aviva World in November here. We also did another presentation as well.
Let's dive into our question. I have a list of questions right here, so I hope it's not going to overwhelm you, but let's dive in. So what is your business and what role are you playing there?
So I'm currently employed by Ovintiv, and Ovintiv is a exploration and production company for oil and gas. Mm. And the role in the organization is I'm the lead of the production operations digital data team, which is responsible for our data historian, or our PI system, and our Canadian field data gathering system, which is our PVR system.
So why this is important to the company you work for?
Well, data is important to companies. Mm-hmm. So being part of a data-centric teams, we look to enable parts of the business by providing them data or using data in many different formats to present new opportunities.
Mm, wow. What's the single biggest problem you would like to solve but have?
So one of our biggest challenges, I think it's a problem for a lot of organizations, is data silos. Is there's many different sources of data between various teams or different various departments. So data silos and kind of the bringing them together is probably one of the hardest things, and in my opinion, to accomplish. Mm-hmm. So we're making strides to kind of get there, but it can be approached in so many different ways. But mm-hmm. we're currently have a model at that we're trying to work with several different groups on to kind of connect all those data silos together.
Mm, wow. And then what if you can bring all the silos together?
It's just having the data and different sets of data provides, I would think, more opportunities to visualize the overall big picture at a company.
Yeah. Okay. And then what are you, okay, go back to me, this is my testimonial. So what challenge were you trying to address before I come on board?
So some of our challenges here was, the team is pretty much short on lack of resources. Mm-hmm. And we had some high value key projects that we needed dedicated resources on, which is one of the reasons why we had you come in and work for a period of time on that project for us. The other one of our challenges was we have a lot of servers that the team has to maintain. And with Windows hardware OS coming end of life next year, we're looking to upgrade our servers to the latest OS and move to new VMs or hardware.
Yeah, right now I'm doing that, right?
Yep.
So I think you kind of mentioned bringing dedicated resources, and how about you explain to us, like, what's the scope of doing that high value projects?
So we have some high value projects that we're seeing. One of them is the rapid anomaly detection project. So that project looks for process anomalies in the field, kind of combining multi-variable state and not so much SCADA alarms, but more indicating a process upset. So in looking and identifying these opportunities earlier has a big cost savings impact to the company. So one of our challenges was, is with the small team, we're unable to dedicate resources to have someone develop the anomalies. To the different groups will create the anomalies for us to look for, but having a dedicated resource to actually build those in the system and to kind of see the process all the way through of implementing the algorithm, building out, testing it, verifying it works, and also the continuous refinement of it.
Yeah.
And that's where we required your help, is to be dedicated to that project and to progress our anomalies further along.
You also helped me so much, right? Like after I put in the code inside Pi System Explorer, you kind of helped me review it and catch my errors, right?
So yeah, just having a second set of eyes on.
Yes, yeah. And I appreciate
would be good
that too.
To
you make me success, you know.
Yeah, okay, for sure.
Yeah. Can you tell us an example of an anomaly that provide the most value?
Well, I think where it first started off for us is we were challenged by one of our senior management. Is we had tanks that were leaking in the field, and they'd often go undiscovered until a site visit by operations. So we wanted to come up with a way to have early identification of these leaks to reduce the volume that were spilt. Mm-hmm. So some of the ways we approached it was to use the PI system and the asset framework to look for drops in the tank level that could indicate a potential leak condition. Mm. So that's one of the anomalies we first started working with, but we not only did we catch a tank leaks, it also caught a lot more for us at our organization, the algorithm that we implemented. So it really opened up a way of different thinking and approaching problems. Is we're finding tank leaks and a bunch of other process anomalies, how can we really visualize it all together and create multiple types of algorithms. So the tank leak kind of evolved into a tank level because it detected more than tank leaks. And from there, it's the idea kind of progressed and grew. But that was kind of one of our original process anomalies we focused on.
And then you start getting buy-in, eh?
Exactly. Yeah, once we saw the wins that we had from the one anomaly, we decided to implement it on a much larger scale and using a bunch of different technologies to best present it to the end user.
And can you describe a little bit what was before that? Management didn't have an eyes on PI is important, right? And when this is the case, if there's no value in using PI, then is it kind of, what do you guys do?
Well, I would say there was a feeling of that PI wasn't important in the organization.
Yeah, yeah.
It's really the evolution of PI at an organization. So the way I like to think of it, and kind of during my time working at different companies, is PI will initially start off as a data historian used for general reporting to make data more accessible to users, for users to kind of self-serve and work with the data. But as you kind of use PI and evolve, you kind of see it as more of a great integration tool on top of that, where it can move data between systems, users able to extract it from one system, put it into another system. And then the kind of the next way I would look at it, the next layer on top of that would be really the analytics and using the calculations on the data to show opportunities. And I think that's kind of how the evolution of, you know, the PI system or data historian infrastructure at Ovintiv kind of evolved. So it was a part of the evolution of where it's at right now in the company.
Yeah, I can see you. Yeah, that's good. You put it this way, yes. It's evolving. Before, it was just a data collection, not utilizing AF, and now you're getting analytics and then detect anomaly.
Yes.
So great. Oh yeah, what I noticed when I worked in this company also, there's different teams involved, right? You guys send the PI system data into the cloud, as well as a machine learning team utilizing the data. So can you tell us a little bit about that too?
Yeah, the data historian infrastructure really fits into what we call the connected data model at Ovintiv. And it's really the collection of systems and technologies, each with its own strengths and weaknesses, that together they make up a much more complete solution. So when we get a request for a data product, we tend to evaluate where it's best, whether it's when we're developing a process anomaly, if it's in the PI data archive or the analysis service, or whether it's in something like a Databricks or data engineering tool. And with that connected data model is that we're able to use kind of the best of both worlds. So in some cases, machine learning might be present more opportunities than writing an algorithm and having multiple passes, not turning out the correct results, but then we can involve the machine learning team. And within the connected data model, it would bring it all together and presenting it at one single pane of glass for a user, really for some of our anomalies.
So three areas together make it a more complete product.
Yeah, multiple areas together. So really like layers of analytics and deciding where certain data products and functionality should really exist within those layers. Yeah. That utilizes really the strengths of technologies.
Yeah, when I work with other team too, like I really see other people, other team bring value to this, enhancing the PI system data value, right?
Yeah. So, yeah. It's really about the strong team collaboration too, mm-hmm. with the various teams involved, is being able to work as a cross-functional team to kind of make it a big success.
Mm, great. So I guess, you know, technology, so I guess Neil and, you know, these different parts involved. How do you, in your opinion, how do you engage people who doesn't know too much about computer, right? Put it this way. And they are restrictive to change, right? How do you get buy-in and then they put this solution out there for people to use?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think a lot of organizations have really problem getting traction with new ideas. And I think the best way to approach it is really to define a certain business objective or a certain problem that you really want to address with what you want to do that kind of fits into the framework. So for example, for us, for our rapid anomaly detection project, one of the first problems was a single point, which kind of expanded from there, the tank leak issue that we're having in the field. Mm-hmm. So once you kind of address a specific problem and have an approach that you think will work and is sustainable and is scalable, and it's really that one initial driver which really starts things at an organization, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. So that really definition of the initial problem.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Wow. It seems like you start giving value first, like from the system, right? And then people starting to eyeball, right? And then upper management see it and then they put money in it, okay?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. So I guess what's the status of the rapid anomaly detection project?
Yeah, the project is really ongoing. We had some key deliverables for 2022, mm-hmm. and we were able to successfully meet all of our objectives and requirements for the year. So the project was on track. So right now it's just kind of expanding the use, adding additional anomalies we're looking at for 2023, but it's been a very successful project for us this year.
Okay, glad to hear. I have little impact on it. I'm part of it. I'm sure everyone.
Big impact, Ricky.
Yeah. Everyone. Like you also, right? Try to get everyone together, right? And I don't know anybody in this company, right? So, you know, that's we appreciate you help me do my work, actually. So,
yeah, of course.
Yeah. So, yeah, I want to talk about impact of the engagement for the rapid and anomaly. So could you tell us a little bit about that? So yeah, what's the impact right now for your company?
Impact is really going from a more of a reactionary approach to a more proactive. Instead of, you know, having users kind of well surfing, which is scrolling through different like SCADA screens to find problems, that problems are pointed out to them. So not only that we will find the problems faster, but we can also catch things before they happen potentially. Mm-hmm. So one thing is we can save equipment from failing, we can avoid production losses, we can increase opportunities, and also look for optimization opportunities with wells or equipment as well.
Mm, wow. And then this, how much, well, you, if you mind, don't mind me asking, how much is the company kind of save for you?
Yeah, we estimated in 2022 that there's millions of savings, multiple.
Wow,
so quite a bit.
Wow. Okay, talk about me. I see the name of show up. So how did Ricky perform from a management standpoint?
Very well, Ricky. Yeah, you did excellent for us. So you're able to come in kind of mid-year for us, halfway through the, you know, this year's project, and really start running with things. I think with your experience and your knowledge, technical skills, and understanding the PI system suite of products, that was really helpful. So your impact was we're able to dedicate your time strictly towards anomaly development and refinement, and that was key in pushing the project forward this year.
I appreciate you said that.
Yeah.
It helped me so much. Oh, my self-esteem, actually, talk about. So, those tough questions are tough. What do you find most impressive about Ricky?
Yeah, I think you're just your knowledge and your skills that you really bring in. You're also your strong and passionate and willing to really make your customers or the people you work with happy. So
we are in the service company, right? If I was, I'm a server in a hotel, then same thing.
Yes. Yeah. But your desire and commitment to the company has been outstanding. So we really appreciate all the work, even all your, you know, after hour support was never expected at, you know, the organization or for your role, but it's always much, much appreciated for, you know, evenings and weekends that we've had issues or troubleshooting. So we greatly appreciate your efforts there too.
I'm glad to help you. I feel you guys are working a lot, and then they should, you know, help. I don't know why, but yeah.
Yeah, so thank you.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Okay, that may be a bad question for me, but what would be the one thing Ricky could do for you to make your career more successful? It's personal now.
What's the one thing? It's hard to pinpoint, Ricky. I would just say continue doing what you're doing. Is, you know, we got a great working relationship here. I think we work well and effectively together. So I would just say to keep up and with your current standards and the quality of work that you're producing, and it's...
Oh, that's it? I don't have to like help you, like, I don't know, I'm thinking maybe talk to your CEO, give the team a raise or something.
Well, that's out of your control, so...
At least I would tell him, right? So, and I have nothing to lose if I... not success, right? So I was thinking about that, but it's okay. Do you have any words to say for those who may want to hire Ricky?
I would say that definitely consider that your services is, we've been extremely pleased with your ability just to kind of come in and start running and producing results from, you know, the first week you got in here. So we'd highly recommend your services to other companies. And I think you're a very valuable resource that companies can utilize.
Wow. Oh, I'm mind blowing with all the compliment now. I'm sure this is not a threat or anything or a buy, or, you know. I thank you for your time. And our audience, if you watch that, and feel free to ask a question to Steven if you want to. So, and then thanks for your time.
You're welcome. Thanks, Ricky.